night! And shoot it!
124 Hefner, start. IMSA, shots fired. Subject down.
The full sequence of events now unfolding 2 months after the high-profile and controversial death of Benny Edwards, a mentally ill and homeless black man.
The officers, they had no choice. They were forced to discharge their weapons.
I'm tired of these police officers that are supposed to protect and serve feel like they have a badge and they can take lives. They could have went about that a whole different way.
It was December 11th. Officers called to a Northwest Oklahoma City pawn shop over reports of a man bothering customers. The situation quickly escalating when the officers realized Edwards was armed with a knife.
You're getting tased!
Sergeant Clifford Holman, a 7-year veteran of the force, first trying to tase Edwards, yelling for him to drop the weapon. At one point, Officer Michael Smith shooting pepper spray. Edwards, however, refusing, eventually charging at them, the knife still in hand. Officer Keith DeRoy firing 3 initial shots as Edwards ran toward him. But then, Edwards making a hard turn, running away from the officers as Sergeant Holman fires 3 more into his back. Of those 6 shots, Edwards was hit by 5 of them, but was then put in handcuffs. It would be another 4 minutes before they checked for a pulse and attempted CPR. On Thursday, the Oklahoma County District Attorney charging Sergeant Holman with manslaughter, describing his actions as, quote, unnecessary and without justifiable cause.
It was happening very fast. I mean, the stress level was extremely high. You know, they did what they felt like they had to do at the time.
We can't bring Benny back, but we can change how the Bennies going forward are addressed.
When does it stop? When do we get justice?
Edwards' body remained here, uncovered for hours after his death as protesters gathered around. Sergeant Holman was the only officer charged in the incident. In Northwest Oklahoma City, Austin Brissett, Oklahoma's News 4.